Alright, so good morning YouTube. Yep. So today I've woken up, eaten breakfast, cracked on a little bit studying, and I'm gonna go do some more now. Gym at 11:30. Sean finished his last exam today, so he's quite lucky. Mine's still in 2 days' time, so tomorrow I got bio, the next day I got geo. So I'm gonna get some last minute cramming in, and then, yeah, not a whole lot otherwise planned until the end. Yeah, then Fumba. I think we leave Friday sometime, so it should be good. Yeah, I'll see you guys.
We're in the shot still, Mavs.
Gym now and about to make some lunch, but we're out of food at the house, so I'm making myself another omelet. Another one. I put 6 eggs in this one though because I'm feeling hungry. And yeah, while I cook that, I'm gonna have one of these naked chocolate mint bars. It's like gluten-free, dairy-free, and it's got quite good macros. Yeah. Not bad. So I'm gonna have one of these right now, naked bar, while I cook my omelet. Now I need to crack on with studying for the exam tomorrow. Fun. Have a meh. Yeah, so I'll see you guys in a little bit. Alright, so what's up YouTube? Just had a shower and it started raining, so I took a break from studying and stuff, and I kind of figured I'd do like my first kind of gym apparel review. So I got here a blender bottle. I just got this. It's a new shaker of mine. So this is quite sick. Like, this is what I like, because check each little like compartment at the bottom has like a lid to it. So that way, like, when you don't unscrew it, like, your protein doesn't just explode everywhere and you end up losing half of it. And it also comes with this little yoi. So these little spring balls. These are quite dope because it's actually like you get a really smooth shake from this. So I'm quite like this shaker. And also it's quite cool. Like, I kind of like the design, like this dark gray, then the black lid and section pieces with the white. It's quite dope. But it also has got this in one of the other compartments. It's a lot of compartments. Let's check this little out at the top. It's like a little thing for all your pills. So if you got like your vitamins or whatever, or pre-workout or creatine, you put those in there and then like lock it in at the top, and then you can still put protein in this without getting into your pills or like your pre-workout. So it's quite dope. I really like this design that they've done, and yeah, I'd recommend buying it if you get the chance. Go buy it. Blender bottle, that's the name. Yeah, it's also got all the measurement in ounces and mils, so quite convenient, because a lot of like the American proteins I buy, like the Optimum Nutrition, it's all in ounces, but then stuff like USN, which is kind of more the UK side, is all in mils, so it's quite nice to have both on the bottle. It's quite convenient. So yeah, first review of a product done. Yeah, I'll see you guys in a bit. I need to hit the books again. Good morning. So today has not gone as smoothly as I planned this morning. It's my car wouldn't start, my Yeah, I had a huge nosebleed when I woke up, so it hasn't really been a good day so far, to be honest. But yeah, on my way to my exam now. I'm gonna hit this on the head, then go to the gym and blow some steam off for chest day. It's chest day, it's the best day. So, yeah, looking forward to it. And then I know I'm gonna do this afternoon. I'm probably gonna have to study again for Geo tomorrow, which is my last exam. So it's kind of like I've got like 30 hours left of this school stuff in my life, and then I'm done. So fuck, just push through, and then I'll see how it goes. So I'll see you guys in a bit when I get there.
Hey, we got a good thing. Don't know if I'ma see you again. But is that a good thing? Cause girl, I can't be your man. No man, I know what's on your brain. You probably hope it never would end. Like, is it the real thing? Or is it just a one night stand? Well then, let me see you get high and go low. Now girl, won't you drop that thing down to the flow? I'm hit for one.
Alright, so I'm home from the gym, YouTube, and yeah, exam went well. I feel good about it. It was kind of like a blessing in disguise because I opened it and I wasn't too sure the first question, but then I kind of read through and I understood all of it, so it was good. I'm quite happy with that exam. And yeah, gym was good. Chest day was good. I didn't film a whole lot. I only filmed a new exercise that I'm trying, which was a altered grip incline on a Smith machine. So it was quite a good exercise. You can feel it quite a lot across the top of your chest. And now I'm gonna have a shake, and I'm gonna talk to you guys for a bit after this shake. Okay, so for those who don't know what go in the shakes, I'm gonna kind of show you again today, so we can go through it now. We got one banana, 100 grams of Greek yogurt, cup of milk, two tablespoons of peanut butter, two raw eggs. And you could just put that on there and blend it. So yeah, there we go.
Hi, Benjamin. Thanks so much for lunch, Benjamin.
No problem.
How was your morning?
It was fine with you?
Yeah, it was good, thank you. Thank you.
And here you go. Shake complete. Should be good. So I'll see you guys in a couple minutes. I'm just gonna finish this and I'll chat to you guys for a while.
Alright, what's up guys? So, I just wanted to talk to you guys about something that I was a bit pissed off about today. And it was my shoulder, so this right shoulder here. So basically what happened 3 years ago, playing water polo, I attained an injury in it, where across the bottom of my shoulder, my right shoulder blade, some of the, I think the tendons or ligaments were torn there. And ever since, it's been causing the long head of my bicep to be pinched in my rotator cuff. Well, that's what the physio told me. So basically it's really painful because it's like a really sharp pain in your shoulder whenever you do anything above shoulder height. So today I was doing incline dumbbell press, and just out of nowhere, bang, came back. And it's kind of disheartening because to be injured again, it took a couple of months of recovery, so I don't really want to go through that again. And it's just irritating. I thought it was fixed kind of thing, and now it's busy being sore all over again. So what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna take it easy for the rest of the week. So I'm not gonna go absolutely like mulky and hard, and I'm gonna go and do some of the exercises the physio gave me to do at home just to kind of fix the shoulder up a bit. But if it gets worse by next week, then I'm going to have to go back to the physio, get him to check it out and see if it's the same problem again or if it's something else that's happened now. Yeah, so it's not the best thing, but it's kind of has to be done. And otherwise, this week, so I didn't really film that much today while we were in the gym, just because it's nothing much has changed in our workout. It's just a couple of variables. I filmed a new really cool exercise that I think you guys would like. I think I told you about it earlier. But yeah, next week, Monday, we start training with Mavs. So we're going to be training with him, and we're going to be doing a whole new program with more cardio incorporated, just to kind of burn a little bit more fat and put on some lean mass. Just not at the same time, but like kind of just a gradual burn and gain, I guess you could call it. Yeah, just getting ready for, just to look good, feel good. Yeah. So the goal is we're going to do 8 weeks of it starting next week, and then we should see some nice results. So I'll start a new series with it next week, and I'm quite looking forward to it because Mav's training us. It's good. Like, we've learned a lot, but I think training with him we'll be able to push ourselves a lot further and a lot harder during the session. So I think it'd be a lot better. But otherwise, yeah, I forgot my bag at the gym today. Yeah, it kind of sucks. So I had all my school clothes and my school shoes and stuff, which I need tomorrow for my last exam. So I asked my mom to pick it up because I only realized when I got home. I was like looking for it in the car and I couldn't find it anywhere. So I gave my mom a call and she was organizing some things near the gym. So hopefully she's picked it up. If she hasn't, I'm going to have to go there tomorrow morning and pick the bag up, which will kind of suck because that means I need to wake up even earlier than usual, which I'm not too keen on. Yeah, but tomorrow's a geography exam. It's 3 hours. That's a tough guy, Bob. I think I'm ready for it. Geography's one of my stronger suits, so yeah, it should be quite good. I'm looking forward to it. But otherwise, yep. That's my life so far. I think I'm gonna go do some studying now, and then when Mum gets home, it's just me and Mum home for dinner. Her boyfriend's out, so I'm not sure what we're having. Yeah, when Mum gets home, just gonna talk to her a bit about the future as well, because I need to talk about it. So I'm not going to university. I don't know if I've told you guys this, because it's kind of a hard choice. Like, it was a hard choice by me because everybody goes to university and you don't want to be the odd guy out. But I've kind of made the decision now that I won't be going to university next year. Instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Canada, Ontario, to live with my dad for the year and work and yeah, catch up and spend a lot of time with dad, because since I've been living here it's been quite hard to see him. So yeah, because it's the other side of the world. So I'm gonna go spend time with him and I'm gonna work and gym there for the year, and if I find what I'm quite passionate about and want to study, then I'll go back and I'll go to university or college the next year, so 2018. Yeah. So if you guys, if you're having like doubts about what you want to study next year, especially if you guys around my age who've got uni or whatever next year and you're not sure, I'd recommend taking a gap year. It just helps so you can clear your head and you can actually like, yeah, know what you want to do, not just what your parents think you want to do. Because a lot of that time that happens, parents are kind of like, hey, you'd be good at this. And then you'd think, oh, yeah, I actually would be good at that. Only because you don't want to be that one guy that doesn't know what he wants to do. Well, fun fact, nobody really knows what they want to do when they're 18. Well, some people do, so I can't really say that. But yeah, some people are really motivated and know exactly what they want to do. Others, we're not sure. We're not exactly sure 100% what we're passionate about. I know I'm passionate about gym, and if I could do something with it, that'd be great. So I will be doing a personal trainer's course next year, and maybe an online trainer's course. I just need to see how things go. But definitely, I want to do something more on the fitness side, because yeah, it's my passion, and I really enjoy it. But then, what to choose for it? Like, there's so much in it. You can be a nutritionist or anything like that. There's like a huge spectrum of stuff to choose within the fitness world. So I just need to discover which part of it that I really want to do. But yeah, otherwise, just choose what you want to do. Don't let your parents force you into anything. That's the main thing.
Alright, YouTube, so yep. Family's not home yet, just me chilling. So I ate supper. I just had sausages and like mincemeat, veg, and yeah, beetroot. I quite like beetroot. So it wasn't too exciting. Watched some TV, did a bit of books, and then, yep, gonna go to bed earlier than usual tonight to try get the sleep in. So I will see you guys tomorrow. And don't forget to subscribe and also check out my Instagram. I changed my name to Wilding Fitness now, so it's easier to find for you guys. So make sure you check it out, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Peace.